So the next very useful activity is an assignment. So you can select the assignment from the list of activity. So when you select the assignment, you can see a list of the setting that you can do. Okay, we're not going to go to each of these, and for some of the setting that we're going to do, we're not going to do it in detail. So we only highlight the setting that you have to do. Okay, for you to start. So first is general, so the title and also the instruction for the assignment. So you can just copy paste from the material that you have prepared. Availability, okay, set the deadline, okay, or the date when the student can submit. Submission type, okay, the type of the submission that you want student to submit. Okay, group submission setting, notifications, grade. So this is where you determine the points from your assignment and also the rubric and also activity completion. So all together, you need to do the setting for this 7 item. So I will show you quickly how this can be done. So let's say this is my lectures, my course. So I just go to, so make sure the turn editing on. So this one has turned on. Just go to add activity, assignment, add. So we should write the name of the assignment. So you should write the instructions. Okay, so after you have done this, okay, so I just reduce this. So you have done the general setting, the assignment name, and also the description. The next is to set the date where you allow the student to submit, okay, enable it, the due date, and also the cutoff date. So the difference between due date and cutoff date is after the due date, the student still can submit the assignment, but the assignment will be labeled as late submissions. If you want to prevent the student to submit after the deadline, you can just click select the cutoff date and then select the date. Okay. So if you want to know more, you can click on the question marks. Okay. So this is going to explain each of these. So after that, the submission type. So you can submit different type of assignment. So for this quick start, we're going to show you only the file submissions. Just select this one. So the student will submit a file. And also you need to determine the number of the file the student can submit for each assignment. After you have done this, just click to the next one, fit the tags. So for this one, I will suggest you to enable the feedback comments and also the feedback files. After the submission setting, you just leave it at default. Group submission setting. So if this is a group assignment, then you need to select student submit in group. Just click yes. If this is an individual assignment, just select no. The next one is notifications. So just leave it as default. Okay. For this one, notify student, just submit no. So just select no. The next one is grade. So this one we will choose the point system. Okay, the grade. So for the maximum point, just write the carry mark. Okay. So for example, this assignment is 5 marks. So in my course, I have 2 assignments, and all together the 2 assignment carry mark is 10 marks. So each of the assignment, I will give 5 marks. So just 5. grading methods, if you select this, they will show you some explanation. So we will only show you the rubric at this moment for a start. Okay. For the rest, just leave it as default. And the next one you have to do is the activity completions. So we will select show activity as complete when the conditions are met. So I will require student to view and also submit the assignment. Okay, only then they will be considered as they have completed this activity. Then the next thing you have to do is to click save and display so that you can immediately set up your rubric. Okay, just click save and display. Okay, so we choose the rubric. So we're going to define a new grading form from scratch. Okay, just click on this. Okay, so I'm going to make it a little bit smaller. Okay. So let's say this is an assignment. Okay, this is a rubric that I have. So you have to prepare the material before you want to do the setting. So first I want to put the name of this rubric. You can write the description also. So in this case, in my rubric, I have three criteria, and for each criteria, I have three labels. Okay. So once this is ready, so what I need to do, I just need to copy paste. Okay. So the first criteria is change of the locations. So this is the criteria. Okay. So the lowest mark is 0 for this criteria. So this is what you usually do for lowest mark. Just put no submissions. Okay. You always put the lowest mark as no submission, 0. And then the second one is this one, partially done. Copy. Paste. So the mark is 0.5. Then the next one is correct. Correctly done. Just copy. Paste. So the mark is 1, the maximum for this criteria. So if you want to add label, you can add more label. Okay. If you want to remove, you can just remove any of this label. So now I want to add a second criteria. So change of feature. For the first one, of course, still the same, just no submissions. The second one, partially done. Okay, so same criteria, same label as the previous criteria. And the last one is correctly done. Okay, and for this one, the maximum mark is 1.5. Partially done is 1. Okay, at the last criteria, which is change of magnitude, just copy and paste. So I can just copy paste because the label is the same. Okay. So the mark is 1.5 for this label. Okay. And the next one is 2.5. So after you have done this, make sure you double check again. So in this case, you can see the combination of each of these criteria, the total minimum mark is 0, and the maximum mark is 1 plus 1.5, 2.5 plus 2.5, so it's the total of 5. Okay, so the student can get the mark between 0 and 5, which is a maximum mark. And then the next thing you want to do is this one. So whether you allow user to preview rubric, okay. So usually I will allow the user to view the rubric. And then just click save rubric and make it ready. Okay. So now the assignment is ready for students to submit their works. So after that, we can just go back to our course. Okay, so this is an assignment.